So we have learned about enthalpy and standard enthalpy change and Hess's law. Now we have to learn about heat of reaction at constant pressure and at constant volume. Okay, when a reaction is carried out at a constant volume in a Baum calorimeter, the pressure within the calorimeter may change but no work done. The heats of the reaction in such cases corresponding to del U. Del U is a change in internal energy. Okay, so you can write the enthalpy change, which is denoted as a del H, is equals to change in internal energy, which is denoted as del U, plus pressure P and change in volume, which is del, which is V2 minus V1, volume. Okay, or you can also write this equation like del H is equals to del U, change in internal energy, plus P del V. Del V is a change in volume. Okay, so according to this equation, no change in a volume. Okay, as a result of reaction, but maybe differ in the in a volume change. For reaction in which the reactant and product are either liquid or solid, no appreciable change in a volume takes place. As a result of the reaction, so the del H and del U are partially practically the same. This may not be so in a case of the reaction involving in a gases. Okay, the change in a volume in a reaction due to the change in the number of the moles of the gases during the reaction can be expressed as for the ideal gas PV is equals to nRT, we all know. So if we replace the P del V from this P V is equals to nRT, so what we get, if we put the value of PV in above a reaction, so P del V is equals to P V2 minus P V1. Okay, so we can also write this is N2 RT minus N1 RT. We just put the value of PV2 and PV1. So it will what we get is N2 minus N1 change in molar concentration, RT. RT is a constant. So finally we get del N RT. So where del N is equals to N2 minus N1. So finally we write del H is equals to del U, which is change in internal energy, plus del N, which is change in number of moles of gases, and RT is a constant. This is the heat of reaction at a constant pressure and constant volume. Now what is the enthalpy of neutralization? The basic concept of neutralization, when the a reaction having the acid or a base, the acid molecule neutralized by the base molecule, simply this is called the neutralization process, and we have to learn about enthalpy of neutralization. So what is the enthalpy of neutralization? The enthalpy change of neutralization is always negative. Okay, the heat is given out when the acid and alkali react. So whenever the acid reacts with the alkali, it releases some heat, and when we learn about exothermic reaction, the heat released, which is denoted by negative. So the enthalpy change for the neutralization is always negative. So for example, if we take example, the dilute hydrochloric acid contains hydrogen ion and chlorine ion in a solution. Sodium hydroxide solution contains the sodium ion and hydroxide ion in a solution. The equation for the any strong acid being neutralized by the strong alkali, essentially just a reaction between hydrogen ion and hydrogen ion to make a water. Okay, you can see this equation NaOH aqueous, and we have take HCl aqueous. If we added both the salts, what we get? NaCl salt and H2O water. So simply the acid neutralized by the base, and we get a water molecule. Simply the reaction what have done, OH ions plus H plus ions, or is negative ions H plus ion combined and make the H2O molecule. In a weak acid, such as acetic acid at the condition of 99% of the acid is not actually ionized. That means the enthalpy change of neutralization would include other enthalpy term involving the ionization, the acid, as well as the reaction between the hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion. And in the weak alkaline like ammonia solution, the ammonia is also present mainly as ammonia molecule in a solution. Okay, so we can take another example, HNO2 aqueous and NaOH. Okay, so what we get? NaNO2 and H2 molecule. So the heat of neutralization is denoted by here a Q, which is a negative. Okay, the heat measured are performed by the carrying out the reaction in a special container which is called as a calorimeter. The heat Q given off by the neutralization reaction is observed by the reaction solution and the calorimeter. Both the solution and the calorimeter increase in the temperature due to the absorption heat. This increases can be measured by the thermometer. Del H is a negative if heat is evolved and the positive if the heat is absorbed. Okay, so here you can see the negative del H neutralization or change in heat of neutralization is equals to Q of solution and Q of calorimeter, the heat of solution and the heat of calorimeter. Okay, now you can see the example. If you take a cold water and if you take a hot water, so the heat of hot water is equals to heat of cold water plus heat of calorimeter. So you can take you can see in this diagram. Okay, if we take a temperature of excess and time in a minute and a excess, here you can see cold water and hot water. What is heat of the heat of neutralization is a constant for cold water, and heat of neutralization for hot water is a descending order. Okay, so In a calorimeter, the heat for the neutralization for cold water is in a form of increasing way, and the heat of hot water is in a decreasing way. Okay, you can only also see the graph for the acid and base molecule. So the acid and base molecule, the heat of neutralization for the acid and base molecule is also found in a descending order. So for the mixture of these salt, the calorimeter show the negative value for the heat of neutralization. Okay, so the specific heat and the deficiency of the solution of the salt formation against the acid and base, you must calculate the del H for the 1 mole of the water formed in the in a system order to compare it to the theoretical value. Del T is the sum of for the solution and the calorimeter.